Let's do some more Halls of Torment. If you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for clicking. Hope you've been enjoying so far. Who do I want to play? I want you. They had success with the cleric, so... I mean, I guess that's my power up, right? Alright. I want to win with the, Hang on. This class struggles later. Well, let's try it. Pick up radius. I'm not quite sure which is the best modifier to scale for this character yet. I'll figure it out, hopefully. I might attempt the other stage since the cleric did well, so we'll see if the cleric can do better in the second stage. Speed. I wonder if there's a cap. Movement speed. I know that's the other one I gotta stay on top of, is like movement speed. Like you almost have to. Fires projectiles. Yeah, I mean, this does wonders, I think. Additional projectiles, okay. Attack speed. Oh, it's only on main weapon. Yeah. We'll see. Pick up radius. Just to proc the amulet's damage. Block. I don't know how useful the extra fragile chances. Oh, nice. Yeah, okay. There's always a certain point that I tend to lose with this character, so we'll see how it goes. Health, damaging an enemy with physical attacks, splash damage. Yep, on that. That's probably good for multi-shot. Piercing, yep. I really want to get something where it's shooting a lot of shots, but I don't know if there's enough time to do it. Oh yeah, cool. Projectiles. It looks like it's throwing those spears more often than lots of three. Gives me health as well. Get health regen. Multi-hit 10% additional attacks. Okay. That should stack with what I have. A second instance of that. I guess this stacks with movement speed, and I got movement speed, so. Okay, again. Yeah, I felt like playing a bit of this today. Like, I'm not playing a lot of this because it's in early access, and I don't want to burn through the content and never play it again. Which is what happens with me in early access games quite a bit. So I'm trying to pace myself with the gameplay. Maybe? I don't know. We have multi-hit, so I guess ring blades will scale with it. How am I doing? Doing alright, just wrapped up work and had some food. Not a whole lot going on. Just looking forward to tomorrow. Seems to be working. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah, I guess we can spin in half. That was the part where I actually had to pay attention. Projectiles. The slimes make things so much harder. Orbit speed, orbit distance, no. I'll just increase damage. Let's just stack the same effect. I think I need to hold off on grabbing the free upgrade on the map until one of my upgrades is like higher up in level. That might be the key to making sure that you get like an upgrade of it. Yeah, just do that. Defense block, base attack damage. Can't really quantify how much more damage it's gonna do though. Like I'm not... I think what would be useful is just seeing some sort of damage stats, and I could be like, well, what is that? What does 10 mean? Because if I'm doing, say, like 5, 10's a lot. If I'm doing 100, 10's not that much. I think for now, probably go with defense. I'm doing roughly 100 damage, so I guess it would have been like a 10% damage increase. Move speed. I'll go pick up radius, because that affects damage right now. So that amulet I got. I'm approaching the point where I usually lose with this character. Piercing. Problem quickly becomes it just does not deal with enough of the horde. That's on orbs. Stressful. Ten percent. Ooh. All right. Go this. I'm gonna trust in the ring blades. Projectiles on main weapon? No. Just in general. Okay. Oh my god. Piercing. Yes. Backwards blades. I think this is the part where I usually lose. It's whenever there's like a lot of slimes on the screen and they become green. Yeah. This is it. Attack speed. This game is so different to Vampire Survivors. In Vampire Survivors, it kind of reaches a point where I can relax, whereas in here it's like the opposite. It reaches a point where I have to pay so much attention. Oh shit. Probably not good. Shit, that was bad. Okay, it's down, but gonna trust that this is gonna work out. It's these slimes. Damage from missing health point. Killing an enemy has a chance to give you a health point. Could probably quantify this. It's like 100 health points is 7% damage. So I have 400. 28%. Or 3% chance to heal. One. But 12% health capacity. I'll take the hood. Hold on. I'll take the hood and I'll go put it in the well so then I can access it later. Assuming I can make it. Oh boy. Yeah, I guess. Lucky. Attack speed, please. Movement speed. Gotta remember movement speed. Plate size damage. Alright, do that. As long as I can make it to the well, I'll be happy.
Let us enter the darkness, where two morbid shrines awaited. Each of them demanded a sacrifice in exchange for a fragment of a powerful token. The token of pain, which betrayed its old master and would yield us the power to finally end his atrocious reign.
I wonder if this is something that I can actually find or if it's just lore. Get it. Okay, that's a lot. I made it. Put the hood in. Okay. Now, just hope for the best. Guess it's probably the one I should take. I don't think my main attack does a lot of crit, but I think my orbs do. Jeez. Additional projectiles. That's distracting. Orbit this, not this one. Health regen. Oh boy. All right. Here we go. Man, you have to get movement speed. I can't imagine being able to do this without movement speed. It's like a hard requirement. There's no chance. Look, some of these things are just barely dodges. Gets faster and faster, that's like the crazy part. This is the furthest I've gotten with this character, so I'm happy, but it's like, I feel like this is an uphill battle. It's the movement speed of this thing, it's just way too quick. I feel like I took movement speed with every single time it came up, and it's still only just enough to avoid stuff. I think they need to tone it down a little bit. Look, I can barely avoid it. And that's with me grabbing movement speed on every single turn. Alright, well. At least I got an item from it. I'm gonna try the second stage with this character, because this character surprisingly did well. Have I killed that thing? I have, yeah. Cleric. Cleric was good. Movement speed is almost like a hard requirement at this point. Okay. I still think health regen is probably like the most important thing, and movement speed. Well, you can do revives. Okay. Revives just got unlocked. I'll do the harder stage. This stage is significantly harder than the other one. But this character is strange. Okay, defense. Because it's harder, the rewards are better. I have no idea. Sometimes harder is just harder. It's just to challenge the player. I haven't really done much of this stage. I just thought, oh no, okay. I'm way too weak for this. And didn't try again. I mean, I don't think there's such a thing as, like, rewards. It's just... you fight stuff and sometimes you get loot. That's good. It doesn't really matter on the stage, I don't think. I might get, like, another character unlocked, though. That might be the incentive to do the stage. That's how it is in Vampire Survivors. More often than not, it's not about doing a harder stage to get a better reward. It's more just for the sake of saying you finished it. Or getting another character. Movement speed that... gotta be movement speed. Yep, that one. Whoa, what is that? Is that a mummy? Oh, okay. I'm not doing much damage to it. Well, this one seems like a no-brainer. The way I was successful with this character is I just made his attack hit for just a big area. So I'm gonna try and do the same thing again. Just try and hit as many enemies as possible. Go defense and build up defense because it has a high natural regeneration. I think I am not doing well because this thing is still alive and the bosses will stack eventually if I don't hurry up. That's better. Alright, what have we got? Lightning strikes. I'll go this. These were good. I'm kind of a fan of these things. Additional projectiles area. Yep. I want thick attacks. The thicker the better. More thick. They need to be like as thick as Wario's booty. Probably gonna pick up Radius. Because I am wearing that necklace that scales with it. Defense. Movement speed. Okay. Here's the second boss. It's moving a lot quicker than what I am. Oh boy. Okay, it's dead. Blame Dancer, apparently, was its name. Okay, let's see what I got for it. It'll probably go in the well. Necklace, on killing a boss or elite, activate health regeneration for 30 seconds, gaining 1%. When you do not use your main attack for 2 seconds, your abilities become stronger over time. Those, I'm gonna get these, not because I think they're gonna be useful on this character. I just get the feeling that's gonna be something really strong and I should take it to the well. So then it becomes an option. So not building attack speed at all. There's no caster from what I've seen so far, so I guess that would mean the next character would be a caster, you would think. I thought this was a caster. But it's more like some a holy man. I don't know how to say it. Like a Templar, I guess. Attack speed. Hell is that? Is that a volcano? No, it's a giant slime. I don't think that's a boss. I think that's just something you run into now. It's probably gonna split into tiny ones. Let's be real. Yeah. It's getting smaller and smaller. Whoop, shit. Hit my pop filter with my headset somehow. Looks like a giant pancake. What? How? No. Trust in this character. Wait, 166 base damage on the weapon. Wide area? No. Thick attacks. You want the extra thick attack. Then you just aim in the general direction and you should be hitting stuff. Oh boy. Not good. Okay, it dropped a scroll. I need to go get it. Range. Alright, let's do the stars. Duration. That would affect the stars, I would imagine. I don't think I'm gonna survive much longer. It's already... It's kind of reached the point where it's really scary already. Yeah. Health regeneration, movement speed. I should prioritize going to the well. I just realized, wait, go to the well, go to the well. Attack speed, just go. Oh no. There are kamikaze enemies. Okay. There we go. Sweet. And this will make up for the experience that I couldn't get. Let's go attack speed. Movement. Crit. Oh, I just realized what that is. It's like a worm thing that's aiming for me. It keeps teleporting around. I'm like, where is that fire coming from? Triple hit. Yep. Those things that it shoots are very hard to see. Like, they kind of blend in very easily. Not that, but... That right there. But I had my mouse cursor on for a while. Surprised there hasn't been another boss. Oh. Okay. There's a slime as well. Yeah. Thick attacks. Okay, adds backward shots. Nice. There we go. Oh, there's a treasure goblin. I mean, treasure slime. Same thing. movement speed and regen. Hold on. Range. Oh crap, this thing's still following me. Range. Okay, I'm going to get the aura. This game's garlic. Range. Look at how wide that is. Oh crap. Whoa. Okay, I see. Jeez. Okay, just don't get behind it is the thing, I guess. Nearly dead. Elven slippers. Increases block while moving. Builds by move distance. Block strength is limited to 10. Movement speed buffs increase the cap. Pick up radius. That sounds cool, the boots. I'm stacking block. It might be worth equipping now, to be honest. Yeah, so the stack count is at 17. I guess orbs. I don't want more spells. I wanted an upgrade to an existing spell. There's one more free spell in the top left corner, I'm going for it. Oh wow. I'm like more than halfway there. Uh, 11% chance to trigger hit effects, all abilities. Okay. To trust in the character. This feels scary right now, but I just have to trust. Dynamite enemies. Okay, I'm back up to full health again. How far is this thing? Been running for ages. Thick attacks. Whoa, okay. Now we got kamikaze slimes. Since this is a character about debuffs. Oh, this was a mistake. Oof. I don't know if the green slime would have been the lesser of the evils there. Duration. This thing is in the back corner of the map. Crit. Okay. No time, grab it. Alright, electrified. Lightning strikes, why not? I have 5 abilities! We don't want the projectile size one. This one. Accuracy. I think this is the most spells I've ever had. Just one away from completely filling up the spell bar. I don't want to make the aura smaller, like... Hopefully the other option appears. If I make it to the boss, this is definitely the best character. Because it would be 2 attempts. I've played this character, what, like 3-4 times? And I've gotten to the boss and beat one of the bosses. It just keeps giving me this. Alright, screw it. Just get it. I need to upgrade it. I can't have it at level 1. Oh man, this boss. So many slimes. Okay, damage or just not thick attack cone, aura damage radius, attack speed, please. More attacks. Okay, crit chance, attack speed, no. That one. Ooh, this boss. Oh boy. Ugh. Pick up. I think I need to be able to pick stuff up easier. I think this has gone well either way. Okay, that's kind of distracting right now. No, I'm fucked. Oh my god. Move away, move away, move away. Oh man. Damn, I really wanted something that was just a generic health up that would have counted as a heal. Okay, things are looking a little better. Holy crap. This boss. Two minutes left. No, health regen. This thing has to die. Got it. Yeah. Look, we don't have a ring. We're taking a ring. Okay. I have, I would say, like, about a minute to try and heal up as much as I can. Ah. Okay, health is looking okay. Health is looking okay. No, it's not! Level 60. Oh, that's tough. I'm gonna go health regen. Just... unbelievably tense. Doing more health, increasing base health. What now? Alright, it's boss time. Health. Whoa. Alright, so this character is definitely the best character. It's no coincidence I've made it up to two bosses pretty much first try. Oh man, this is scary. I am not doing much damage to it. Also, these ball things, they seem to be blocking my path more and more to the point where, like, I can't get close to them. And they don't seem to be getting destroyed. We're gonna be here like 10 minutes, if not longer, assuming I don't die. I'm trying to be more aggressive. Definitely made more of a dent now. As long as he doesn't pull any surprises, I think I'm okay. Ah! Oh, that got me good. Okay, halfway there. I'm getting achievements everywhere. No! Oh. Oh, that was such bad timing on that sword coming out. Shit, he's like well guarded right now. Okay, what am I supposed to do about that? He's completely surrounded. Okay, I can kinda reach him here. Oh, this is bullshit. What am I supposed to do as the character that's like completely melee? I think the first boss is harder in my opinion. This one's just more annoying. Like, I could just walk away and be fine. And just go heal. Like, what's stopping me from doing that? Just walking away. Okay, that's what's stopping me. It wraps around. You know what? It kind of helps. It does disperse them a little. I think I just have to try and detonate them without, like, messing up, because there's a lot of them. There's too many of them. Like, I can't get to the middle anymore. I have to do my best to detonate them. Wow. What a fight. I think honestly the shurikens are carrying because they do walk into them and it does do damage, so I think that's honestly what's doing the most right now. It's just because they're lingering a lot. I'm sorry! This fight's gonna go forever. I'm trying my best to detonate them so it clears a path, but there's just too many. They just keep coming back. I think that's the intent of this fire, is it's just supposed to get to this point. Oh my god. I don't know if I can win this. This almost seems like it's untenable. Okay, that's a good spot here, right here. This is good. There we go. I got back into a sort of okay position. I just need to keep detonating these things. Oh shit. It's back to being annoying again. Okay, move, 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 move. I think I just have to keep moving along the screen and then eventually kind of get into this position where he's not defended. Like there. Ah! But this fight is so much worse than the first one. No, no, no! Ugh. Okay. Is this gonna be a case where I'm just gonna lose, ultimately? My attacks just barely reach it. Can't even get close to him anymore. I'm probably gonna lose. Okay, I caught a break. Sort of. Ugh. I have to be aggressive, I'm gonna lose. This needs to get toned down. There's too many. And it happens so quickly. This boss is like a sponge. Keep running. Okay, there's a window, there's a window. Until I have like a spot where I can do this to him. Okay, move away again. There we go. Come here. He gets blocked in by his own shit. That's the problem. Like, he tries to run out of it, but he can't. Okay, move away.
Oh, man.
I'm trying my hardest. Okay, good spot. Come here. Just need to get into a spot where he can run away from these balls, and then I can hit him. Oh, this is getting extremely cramped. Oh boy, I'm in trouble. Oh. The space for me to run is getting smaller and smaller. I don't know. I feel like there should be a cap to how many of these things he should be able to have out. So it just comes a point where I just cannot hit him anymore. Not having much luck with the Reapers. There we go, there we go, there we go, there we go. Come here. Getting closer. Just need him repositioned in the spot like this. I'll tell you this much, I'm glad I went regen. It's honestly carrying. I think I definitely prefer the first boss over this one. This one feels like a sponge, and then these things just become an obstacle more than the challenge. Move away. Just gotta find a spot where it's not surrounded. Oh shit. That. I have to stand still for just a minute, just to let them kind of clump up like that. Ugh, you stupid sword. Come on. This is probably the most damage I've done for a while. Damn it. got surrounded again. So annoying. No, that's too far in now. Oh, you're not dead. Come on. Oh. Okay. Don't do that again. Oh, shit. Not good. Dude, just please. Oh my god, it's still not dead. Would be on the smallest slither of health. I can't find an opening. Ah, but, oh shit. Wait, but. Why aren't these disappearing? Oh, come on, man. Okay, but they don't increase. Just, I guess, thin them out by walking near them, but not through them. Why don't they vanish with the boss? This just seems so unnecessary. I can't even run down in the direction of it. Oh no, I am not a fan of this. This is... Okay. Okay. Change direction. Here we go. I guess I can run through it as long as I'm quick enough. This is such a major inconvenience. I'm gonna be a little annoyed if I can't get that because of this. Okay. Got it. Oh, that was an effort and a half. I'm not sure how long that went for. Jeez. Well, I got the Warlock and I got the Exterminator. I think it's safe to say this character is strong. I don't think I could have done that with any other character, at least out of these three. The Archer would have died, like, at the start of the fight. And the Swordsman would have been completely useless the moment it got up to that point where, like, the boss was surrounded by those orbs and I just could not get near it. All right. And I can purchase these. Which, yeah. It would appear that probably good timing on it. All right. But we'll leave it for next time. I need to take a break now. I'm gonna go and make a beverage and we're gonna swap games. But if you're here for this, yeah, thanks for tuning in. Or if you're watching later on YouTube, hope you enjoyed this one. I need to, like, wear that stress away for a couple of minutes before I start the next game. But if you enjoyed the stream, just remember to click buttons. Or maybe two videos have popped up if you're watching on YouTube later and you want to watch me play something else. Alright, bye YouTube.